All right, guys, we're back in my garage for another episode of the B58 Digest, and today we're going to be talking about a new topic. But before we hop into the video, I did just want to give you guys an update on the B58 Digest. We're going to be doing things a little bit differently moving forward and kind of trying out a different way of putting these videos together. So if you guys haven't noticed, I've been posting these on Mondays, and typically what I do is I put all the developments and updates that I see throughout the week, put that together in a video over the weekend, and upload it on Monday. And this isn't always the easiest way to do things. Sometimes it's actually pretty difficult. And especially on a week like this week, where you guys have seen literally all of the tuning companies are coming out with updates at the same time, it makes it hard for me to make a good video that isn't like 20 plus minutes long. So I'm going to be releasing more videos that are hopefully shorter length and more focused on individual topics. So that way, you know, if you guys are only interested in a specific platform, then you don't need to watch, you know, all the videos. Or maybe you just don't care about people hitting, you know, new dyno records and supers resetting their quarter mile records every week. So, you know, you can kind of pick which videos you want to watch. And also it'll make it easier for me to put out more relevant content to the channel. So hopefully you guys enjoy this change. You know, feel free to leave feedback down below if you have feelings either way. And we'll see how this goes. So today's topic comes from MG Flasher, and what they've done is enabled support for DMEs that were previously locked. So if you have a car after the July 2020 cutoff date, you know that you needed basically a big bench unlock from FEM2 over in Europe in order to flash your car. And now you're able to do that with MG Flasher as well. So you can do either the cloning route, or you can go and have them actually unlock your DME on their bench unlock tool. And then when you get your DME back, you're going to be able to flash your DME through the OBD using the MG Flasher app. So basically your car will be just like any other car that was unlocked through the OBD port. But of course it'll take a couple weeks to send it over, get it unlocked, and get it back. Now this is a big deal for anybody that's willing to, you know, pay the money and take the downtime to have that work. Especially if you're not using your car right now much in winter, maybe this is the best time to go and get that done. But it's going to be great because you don't have to send your DME back and forth to get the flashes updated anymore. You're going to be able to do everything through the OBD. You can get custom tunes set up, and basically all of that will be just like any other, for example, Gen 1 B58. So this will work for the M3 and M4 as well as the X3M. It also should work for like Supras, M340Is, and anybody with those later model DMEs. MG Flasher was one of the first for B58 tuning, so they have a lot of experience under their belt, and they have a pretty big custom tuning network as well that more and more people are beginning to jump on board with. So this is just a really nice option to have for people that maybe don't want Ecutech, want something that's a little more simple, and potentially they'll even offer off-the-shelf maps for those S58 cars. I'm not sure if that's available yet. So yeah, I think a lot of people didn't realize that after FEM2's unlock, you can't just flash whatever you want. Your tuning company needs to basically work with them to enable their software to flash through the OBD after that unlock has been completed. So now MG Flasher has that as well. Now keep in mind, something that I think a lot of people didn't realize is if you have a Gen 1 B58 or an earlier model and you get a software update, the MG Flasher tuning suite does not support that yet. So if you get a software update at the dealer, even if you get a bench unlock, they will not be able to flash your car again afterwards. So they're still working on that, but this is for the actual late model cars that didn't have any flashing options to begin with. You are now able to flash your car with MG Flasher. So yeah, hopefully I didn't beat that dead horse too much and you guys got the information you needed. Thanks again for watching, and if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Do 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 do